All right, here from PPL Park in Chester. Huge win for the Blue Hens today to close out the regular season. Third straight win, a big rivalry win, 26-16 over Villanova. Coach, great effort tonight. Again, your mantra of just go out and play, and they did that tonight.
Yeah, you know, you wish in the middle of the season we would have, you know, got that mantra down a little bit earlier because things weren't going our way, and Villanova made some plays. I think they did a great job with their 2 weeks off. They came out with a couple things offensively that we hadn't seen in the past and, you know, made some plays on us, and we kept it steady. And we got a little conservative at the end of the game. We wanted to kick that field goal and put it on the shoulders of our defense, but I have so much faith in Sean Boehner, and Sean got it done, put the ball right through the middle of the uprights. Defense comes out, and you know, we got a pick six, which I'm hollering at Ricky, just take a knee because the game's over. He just takes a knee. But it's tough, you know. I mean, when you make a big play like that, you see you have the sideline. Tough not to score.
Rick, a play of Ricky the last 2 weeks just coming up big. Also, that's not even to mention the interception in the end zone to that first turnover. Just big game.
Absolutely. You know, I think we got to give Michael Allen to Rossi a lot of credit. He called out the eligible receiver where they try to give us a trick formation. They put the tight end in as a tackle, and they try to roll away from him and get him down the middle of the field, and Michael called it out. We got a big pick in the end zone. So, yeah, you know, Ricky's come up big. As I said, you know, Ricky's his own worst enemy. You know, he thinks he's a better corner. He thinks he's a better wide receiver. Let him play safety, Ricky. You're going to be fine playing safety. So I think he realizes that now.
What's it like to finally wrestle that battle, the Blue Trophy, back from Villanova after five seasons?
Yeah, you know, I mean, we clearly thought we had the better team. And, you know, not to get this one would have been very disappointing. But, again, I have to give them so much credit because, you know, not a lot to play for when you're 2-8. And those guys came out, and there's a reason why it's a rivalry game. So congratulations to our kids and also a lot of credit to their kids.
Right, so 7-4, end of regular season. Coach, you know, the big 800-pound gorilla you talk about, elephant we talk about. What's the hopes for tomorrow, and what do you think is going to happen?
Well, I don't know what happened nationally, and I'm not going to worry about what happened nationally. I'm not going to go look it up on the computer. I'm just going to just figure it out when we get home, when I wake up Sunday morning. But we're the only team in the country with two top 10 wins, only team. And we won the last three games of the season, and we play in the toughest conference in America. So to be in the top 15 in the country and have two top 10 wins and we don't get in, that'd be a real shame.
All right, there you have it. Final score, 26-16, the Blue Hens over Villanova, closing out the regular season 7-4. Stay with us tomorrow to see the postseason hopes for the Blue Hens. Now over to Jimmy Smith with Ricky Tunstall.
Thanks, Scott, here with Ricky Tunstall, hero of tonight's game. And Ricky, you know, four interceptions in 2 weeks is incredible, but this particular interception to win the game and house it, take me through the emotions. When you had the ball in your hands, when did you know you were going to take it to the house?
When I caught the interception, all I seen was touchdown, because when I got the ball in my hands, I feel as nobody could tackle me, so I just ran to the end zone.
What have you been doing right the last 2 weeks? I mean, four interceptions is a lot, and you know, with what you've done in key moments, especially tonight, those have been huge. But what have you been doing differently?
Probably watching more film. The film room is like another place to go when you're bored, so I just went there. Watched a couple more of films, know their tendencies, and I guess I got lucky and he threw the ball right to me.
All right, so we knew that we needed to get the win here to keep our postseason playoffs alive, and it probably helped to get a 10-point win rather than just the 3-point win. But what's your plea to the people that make the decision to put the Blue Hens back in the playoffs?
I mean, we deserve it. Like, we was in the championship last year, so like, why not give us a chance to go back again, try to do it again?
One of the big concerns with you guys this year was the secondary, and you guys have squashed all of that between Hawkins, Burley, Breaker, and yourself, I think, and Justy, and everybody's figured everything out. As a unit, how have you guys grown?
Well, in the beginning, we were a little shaky. We wasn't together, but as we grew, like, we used to have one-on-one meetings after the coaches left, just the players, and we like, look, it's on us. Like, every game is on us. They're going to put it in the air because we're young. We just got to make plays.
Ricky, congratulations. Here's hoping there's more football.
Yes, thank you.
It's Ricky Tunstall. The Hens win it 26-16 over Villanova, and playoff hopes are still up in the air. The selection show is tomorrow. Tune back to BlueHens.com for that. For head coach Casey Keeler, for Ricky Tunstall and Scott Selheimer, I'm Jimmy Smith. Thanks for clicking on us right here on BlueHens.com.